بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Aneeqah Sheikh, myself Aneeqah Sheikh, a dental surgeon intern from St. George's Hospital, which is supposed to be first in Maharashtra and third in India, I guess. So I know it doesn't matter. I have this vision. Whatever I am studying from, wherever, doesn't matter. We have millions of doctors in Mumbai, or Bangalore, we cannot even think. So this thing was clear. But when I came here, I knew one thing. Okay, I am a Muslim, I am attending this lecture, please cover myself. But you know what happened when I came here? Our coach, he told us he is our coach. I said, okay, I accept it. He threw a very burdenful, hard on my face, and that question was, who am I? I was like, okay, I'm a Muslim, I know that. Like, why do you think you're a Muslim? I said, because I said, La ilaha illallah. He said, really? Really say La ilaha illallah? I said, come on, sir, I really said La ilaha illallah. He's like, okay, so do you know what La is? Do you really differentiate La from ilaha illallah? I said, okay, what is it? Now I cannot say at this stage, myself, Aneeqah Sheikh, who came 3 days back out here, I cannot say. I was responsible, accountable, grateful, just, and focused on other generous. 3 days back I was in this. But when this question was, that time I was like, okay, I have just said La ilaha illallah, let's see what La is. This diagram, this posture, is just my story, what I discovered here. Our coach told us, in order to know about La, which I've highlighted in red, ye cheez pata karne, I need few prerequisites, okay? And the first prerequisite which I could remember, sir, though he told us a lot of, I could remember, the most important one was setting higher context. Okay, so he told us, once you set higher context, it will lead you step by step to a mission. Once you have a mission, you have a vision. Like this vision, this mission, well, what is our ultimate mission? Come on. It is love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're clear about it, okay? So this mission will lead you to a vision, and now you have a clear vision that we need to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This mission, it gives you the ability, salahiyat deta hai wo aapko distinguish karne, farak karne, kis cheez mein, internal ko external se, am I okay? External is what you can see, internal you don't know who I am, and then I discover I myself don't know who I am. So he told us, internal apna dekho, external dekho, to internal to dikhta hi nahi tha, tin din pehle external hi tha, jo ultimately internal bhi banke baitha tha. Okay, so he told us, how is your external? And he explained us in such a way that I realized my external was quite filthy, unacceptable, and it was terrible. It was full of anger, frustration, judgmental, and a lot of things which I wouldn't want to mention here. So he told us, yeh aisa kyun hai? Because we are living a life which is outside in. Bahar jo ho raha, this is all bahar ki cheez, everything stuff bahar ka. But I have let these bahar ki cheez to enter into myself, which has become my internal as well. Told us, aisa nahi hai lekin, we are actually not this kind. We were very pure, and we are actually very pure. We are very nice, we are very clear. The only problem is that, now your internal is actually ruled by someone known as Kareem. Okay, who is a devil? जो हम सबके साथ ही जुड़ा हुआ है. अभी जो करीम है, he is evil and he is not okay. And he distorts our view and he decepts us. धोखा दे देता है और एक distortion डाल देता है. So he told us, clear the view. ये जो distort हो गया आपका view, यानी जो clear it out. He said, okay, I cleared the view. After I cleared the view, I could sense, now I can live a life which is inside out. And it is the most amazing feeling when you do it. You don't judge people. Now I am like, I don't judge people. I don't care what others do. or I care about my own self. This way I became inside out. Now my inside rules my outside, and my outside does not rule my inside. Okay? Then the next step, he will ask, what happens? Move on. There are a lot of consequences of a lot of things. We are yet to come to choices. My external makes me suffer. It makes me feel opinions. So he told us, what you need to do is that when you have cleared your view, you are clear, you are pure. Now you need to make choice. Okay? Okay, I said, okay, I've made choice. He told us, choice, kiske beech mein banoge? You have options. Good, evil, etc., etc. But the most important is haq, that is the truth, and the batil. Haq will lead you to submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and submission to all the goodness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created. And batil will lead you to denial. You will deny everything in your life. You will deny your reality, you will deny the fact, you will deny the truth and whatnot. Then I realized, okay, batil job tak mera tha. What happened? Batil has led me to form a self-fabricated truth. And this has led me to form opinion about each and every person, each and everything I see. So this is all gone, okay? So this ultimately led me to suffering. So yahan se bhi aaya tha, jo yahan se bhi aaya. This has ultimately disconnected myself from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But up to now I was in delusion ki I'm a practicing Muslimah, which I realized I'm not. Then I moved ahead. Okay. Now, haq ke saath ek aur cheez hai ki Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ne has granted us, has bestowed us with three main, very, very important faculties. Okay, these are sense, realization, which is your heart, the third one is rational, your brain. And we are all machines out here who runs with our brains. So, sir told us, don't go, don't rationalize everything. You don't need to reason everything. Somebody is telling you something, fire about somebody. Quran is saying you this, you have no option to ask. Why? He's saying you do this. Okay, do this. He's saying you do that. Okay, I'll do that. Why? Because there is no place for rationalization and reasoning in Quran. Okay? So I said, okay, so I'm not going there. Because it is taking me to again batil, then batil to opinion, then to suffering. Told me, hold on to your realization, that is your qalb. Once you hold on to this, I take step to step to haq. I submit myself. And then what do I do? I stop my kareen, and then this kareen ultimately has no control over my internal. Once I submitted myself, then I realized the reality, the fact, the truth. Then I became responsible, I became accountable, I became integrity, I was just, I was generous, I was grateful. Most importantly, I started focusing on the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This made me to final declaration of La ilaha illallah, which has finally granted me my heart at peace and not at war, which disconnects me from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Once my heart is at peace, my life is happening. Jazakallah khairan.
Subhanallah.